Welcome students in my YouTube channel which is Biology by Mahesh sir. Today we will take the next topic which is plant water relations, topic related to the botany and in RBSE for 12th it is chapter 5th and for in NCERT it is a plant physiology for class 11th. Here, so it is a botany chapter which is first topic is diffusion. So first of all, definition of diffusion. Definition means the process by which particles move from higher concentration region to lower concentration region is called diffusion. So definition is the process by which the particle of any substances move from higher concentration region to lower concentration region is called diffusion. So which substance particle involved in it? Obviously liquid, gas and solid particle. The particle of liquid, gas and then solid move from their higher concentration region to lower concentration region is called diffusion. Okay? So it is the definition of diffusion. Now second we take the process of diffusion. Process of diffusion we can take example of diffusion in plants. Especially in plants, first of all, photosynthesis, clear? We can take example of photosynthesis. For photosynthesis, it is a plant cell which require carbon dioxide. So low concentration of CO2 in plant cell, it is plant cell. And here high concentration of CO2 in environment. So from higher concentration region to lower concentration region, carbon dioxide move inside the cell of plant by the process of diffusion. So it is the process by which diffusion takes place in the plant cell. So second topic we have completed, which is the diffusion process. Now in this process we can take the carbon dioxide is required for photosynthesis in plant. So plant contain the low concentration of CO2. That time the CO2 concentration in environment is high. It move from outer side to inner side by the diffusion. Now after the process we can take the factor affecting the diffusion. Or before factor affecting, we can take example of diffusion. First of all, in plant, photosynthesis, in respiration, that means CO2 intake, that means oxygen release into the environment. Third example, intake of nutrients from soil. So these are the example of diffusion in plants. Now after diffusion we can take the common example of diffusion. The diffusion is process means from the higher concentration region to lower concentration region, clear? So movement of any substance from higher concentration region to lower concentration region, in which we can take example of spray bottle. The spray bottle contain the high concentration of spray content, clear? And in surrounding environment it contain low concentration of spray content. So from higher concentration region to lower concentration region, the spray material move after the spray. So it is called diffusion, clear? So it is an example, it is common example, and these three example related to the plant Clear? Next we take the factor which affect the factor which affect diffusion in plants. Factor affecting plant diffusion. First factor, which is temperature. Now, if temperature is high, what happen? Kinetic energy of substance molecule become high, and due to high kinetic energy, the rate of diffusion increase. So temperature high, that time kinetic energy of molecule increases and rate of diffusion become high. We can take the second example. If temperature low, that time kinetic energy also low and the rate of diffusion also decreases. So it is the effect of temperature on diffusion. Again repeat, the high temperature, that time high rate of diffusion, low temperature, the low rate of diffusion. Second, second is density of diffusion particles. Clear? So we can write rate of diffusion inversely proportional to the density of particle. So meaning of this equation is that when first we can take, if density high, that time rate of diffusion low. Clear? If this density is low, that time rate of diffusion increases. So it is the second effect of density of diffusion on particles. Now third, which is concentration gradient. Or concentration, when the concentration gradient apply, it is a cell which contain low concentration of any substance, any gases, and here in surrounding it is the high concentration. So it create the concentration gradient. If concentration gradient is high, that time it increases the rate of diffusion. If the low concentration region or gap between the two concentration is a low, that time it decreases the rate of diffusion. So when concentration gradient increases, when the difference between the concentration gradient is low, that time rate of diffusion decreases, and difference is high, that time it increases the rate of concentration, rate of diffusion. Next is importance of diffusion in plants. Fourth point, which is importance of diffusion in plants. First, in gaseous exchange, that means O2 release into the environment and then carbon dioxide enter into the plant cell by the diffusion process. So for gaseous exchange. Next, second is evaporation, or we can say the transpiration. help in third, help in absorption of minerals or nutrient from soil without the use of energy. So importance of diffusion in plant, first of all, it help in exchange of gases. It release the oxygen by diffusion, it enter carbon dioxide by diffusion. Second, help in the transpiration. Transpiration means the excess loss of excess water from leaf is called transpiration. And third, help in absorption of nutrient from soil. Soil contains the nutrient material. These nutrient material enter into the root by the process of diffusion. So it is the importance of diffusion in plants. Clear? So it is the first topic which is related to the RBSC chapter 5th in 12th and NCERT plant physiology 11. Clear? Thank you for watching my video. You can take a screenshot of this diagram.